If you already have a simple GraphQL API that you would like to be able to consume using Angular, in this Quick Tips episode, you will learn how. Keep watching! Hi there! I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So, if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start! In previous videos, I created a simple GraphQL API using Nest.js that returned some information about quizzes and questions. In this video, I will create a client application using Angular, configure the GraphQL client, create an Angular component that consumes the Quizzes GraphQL API, and finally start the Nest.js server and the Angular app to see the results. Let's start by creating the Angular application. Open a terminal and make sure that you have the Angular CLI installed. Using the CLI, let's create our client application. Select if you want to enforce stricter type checking, add routing, and what to use for CSS styles. Once that's done, change to the directory of the new app. Let's configure Apollo Angular to connect to our Nest.js GraphQL server. Start by using the CLI to add the Apollo Angular dependency and pass the URI for the GraphQL endpoint. If you open the graphql.module.ts file located inside the app folder, you will see that some required configurations like the Apollo client with the URI for the GraphQL API and the in-memory cache with also the GraphQL module were automatically created for us. If you open the app.module.ts file, you will see the GraphQL module already added into the app module as an import. Let's create the Angular component and the query needed to get the data from the GraphQL API. For storing the queries, create a folder called GraphQL. Then, inside it, create a GraphQL.queries.ts file. Import GQL from Apollo Angular. Similar to what was done when testing the GraphQL API using the playground, define the query to get the quizzes and their descriptions using GQL, and then export it. Using the Angular CLI, let's generate a component inside the components folder called quizzes, and given that we have two modules, one for the app and one for GraphQL, specify that the component should be added to the app module. Inside the components and quizzes folder, open the quizzes component, import Apollo from Apollo Angular, and import the query we've just created. Inside the quizzes class, add a quizzes array, a loading flag, and an error object. On the constructor, inject Apollo. On the ng-onInit method, use Apollo, the watchQuery method, and pass the query. Then, use the valueChanges property and subscribe. Whenever there are changes, from the results object get the list of quizzes if they are available, the loading flag, and the possible error. Open the components template. If the component is still waiting for the data to come back, I will show a loading text message. I will also just show in case of errors a text message. Once Nest.js returns some data, iterate through the quizzes array and render the title and the description from each quiz. Go to the app.component.html file, look for a div with the attribute role equals double quotes main, remove everything but the clouds from it, and add the app-quizzes element. Start the Nest.js and the Angular dev server. If you don't have the GraphQL API locally, create a new terminal window, clone the Nest.js repository for this series, change to the newly created directory, install all packages using Yarn, and start the server. Switch to the previous terminal and start the Angular dev server. On the browser, open localhost colon 4200, and once the page loads, you should be able to see the list of quizzes. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.